welcome to my funny reading journal spread setup video. I just finished reading Bunny 2 days ago, and I have not been able to get it off of my mind, so I decided to do a reading journal spread tribute to the book. This first page that I'm doing, I'm just painting it pink, and I'm trying to kind of emulate the cover of Bunny. And then after I finish this, I move on to the page on the left where I'm doing my own bunny inspired burning muffin and cupcake quote art. Please enjoy the rest of this pink painting before I move on to the bunny. Here we are. So then I just sketched out the outline of the bunny itself. I just freehanded this, and I wasn't trying to get the exact same looking bunny, just any sort of bunny outline was enough for me. I'm just doing that with a black pen. Watercolor underneath these pens is actually really bad for it, so I ended up ruining quite a few pens yesterday when I did this. Hopefully, maybe some ink went back down to the bottom and they're salvageable. But yeah, I switch black mediums a few times throughout this. I switch to a Sharpie and then end up with black watercolor, which looked the best anyway, so it worked out. Thank you. and we're done with our bunny. So I moved on to my muffin slash cupcake spread. My idea for this one was based off of the quote about burning muffins that comes up throughout the book, and the stench of it that is always kind of permeating from the darlings. And so I decided to do some muffins on fire. Then I had the idea as I was looking at them that one of them could be a cupcake, since one of the bunny's names is Cupcake, or her nickname is. So yeah, I just outlined some of my pencil and got rid of some of the lines. I did a lot of erasing before I went in with watercolor. Started with too big of a brush, but I fixed that pretty quickly. Yeah, and switched to a smaller one. And I just googled like a stock cartoon image of what fire looks like and tried to emulate that. I was going for a cartoony sort of version of it, and as I kept working with the watercolor, things were just blending without my trying to blend them. And then as I saw them blend, I kind of enjoyed the way that looked, so I started blending. So I really liked the way that the fire came out, so I'm starting with yellow at the bottom, and I moved on to like a peachy sort of color on top of it, and some orange and red. This was just like, I think when you're trying to draw fire, I've never drawn or painted fire before, so these like U-shaped pointed tops, I feel like really give the flame feeling to it. So yeah, then I'm just outlining this top part with the peach color and layering those. Just doing some blending here. My camera cut out for a little bit of the parts where I was blending, so it skips a little. But then I moved on to this quote that I'm doing on top of the burning muffins. That was said by Rob Valencia before he combusted. So the quote is, our heart, we've read Jane Eyre too, you cunt, and we've read The Waves, and when we read it, you know, we wept for minutes. I just thought that quote was hilarious when he said that, and just so, it just sums up the bunny's relationship with our narrator, who I don't remember the name of right now. Oh, Samantha. Just sums up how they feel about her, and kind of her as well, just like the way that she feels that they're so pretentious and they're so pretentious and annoying, but she also goes to this school, she's just as pretentious. They read the same books and it affected them all. They're a lot more similar than Samantha thinks they are. And I just thought this quote was just so funny. And I wanted to make a spread out of it, so I added in this little clock, and then I'm just getting rid of some of the pencil markings from where I was drawing out the quote, and I was considering just leaving it like that, but I do go in and add more. I just did some more blending here because I thought that red was looking kind of harsh, so I was like spreading it out a little bit, trying to make the flames a little more round at the bottom and pointy at the top of those curves. And then I decided to make the quote into like a cloud of ash / smoke that's like floating away. So I start that after blending. So here's where I started doing the cupcakes, the muffins, the muffin tops. Just went in with a few different shades of like gold and brown. I wanted them to be a little bit different, but in hindsight, I think if I were to have done this again, I would have made them more identical, just because the bunnies are all kind of the same. Like in part two of the book, they all just kind of blend together and become identical, non-discernible of who is talking and what desires we're hearing. But I decided on making them different in this moment because I had already made Cupcake stand out, and it wasn't because I thought Cupcake was a standout character necessarily. Like, she was, if anything, I would think like the Duchess was the most standout of the four of them. But since Cupcake was standing out, I was like, okay, maybe I should make them all a little unique, because it's not like she's the leader or anything. I even considered like doing little tributes to their nicknames on all of the cupcakes, like adding a little tiara for the Duchess, doing something ballet related for Vignette because she was a ballerina, and some sort of creepy doll aspect for Creepy Doll, but I decided not to. I thought plain muffins looked okay, and I just couldn't really visualize how I would get those characteristics into muffin form. So I just made them blueberry and threw some like sprinkles and sparkles onto cupcakes icing. Now, here's where I tried doing the ash smoke cloud thing, and it looks like a gray color in the watercolor tin, but it came out very green, and that was pretty sad. I tried to blend it out like a lot, and it just kind of stayed there. It wouldn't really go anywhere, so it's just there now, just part of the part of the picture. I'm looking at the finished product right now that it's dry, and it looks a lot better. The green blended in with the actual gray. It's more of a purpley gray because my painting tin didn't actually have a gray itself, so it was more like a mix of purple and I don't remember what I mixed it with. Purple and something that seemed like gray but wasn't quite gray. So it's got a purple hue, which was, I thought it went fine with the outline of the clock since I painted that purple, and then I didn't feel like painting around the clock, so I just write over it, which meant that the purple on the clock actually bled a little bit. I didn't expect that to happen because the rest of it wasn't really blending, so, but it was okay, it didn't blend that badly. After I finished the ash cloud, I thought the words were looking kind of dull, so I decided to go over it again and holden them up a little bit so they would look bold. Now here I wanted to write Bunny, but I wasn't sure if I wanted to make it exactly like the cover of the book, so I decided to use these stickers because I was also nervous about actually handwriting the word and messing up this bunny that took me forever. So I decided to go with these stickers that I thought fit the vibe pretty well since they were also black. They're sparkly, it's kind of hard to see, but they are sparkly, and I wrote Bunny down the right side of the page, and I really like how that came out. And after that, I added a little heart sticker in the middle of the clock because I tried to paint a heart on there and I didn't love it. But then I had the sticker that my boyfriend gave me that was just randomly like from New Orleans, and there was a little part of it that said roadkill. I thought that was kind of the vibes. Although roadkill is never mentioned in the book. Actually, there is one scene where a bunny gets run over, so yeah, I thought that was just like aesthetic. And then in the bottom right corner, I kind of just wanted to add some more stuff because I felt like the bunny page was pretty plain. So I decided to draw one of the pair of axes that are on the inside cover. And the axe is a pretty big symbol throughout the book, and I love Max. Oh my gosh, I have never made that connection. Max, axe is in the name Max. Did anybody else realize that, or am I just slow? Or did I just do something? Yeah. Okay, well, I drew these axes here, which took forever. Far longer than I thought that this would take, and this whole video is sped up 4x speed, so the actual time it took me to make this spread was, it's a 26 minute video, so 4x that, and I did cut out some of the things that I did, like some of the blending, or like the painting of backgrounds and such, so probably like 2 hours on the whole spread, maybe even a little bit more. But it was fun. I really like bullet journaling and painting. Although I don't paint very often. I'm not an artist. I'm not familiar with art, with watercolor. This is the first time I've used watercolor in my bullet journal, and I don't know if I'm a fan. It really like crinkles up my pages a lot. So maybe only on certain pages. Yeah, because the pages of my notebook are super thin, so I actually tape pages together or like glue them together. So like where that bunny is, the following page, everything bled through, which I knew it would do. It always does. So I tape the bunny page to the next page, and like the page with the fire, the cupcakes on fire, that was already taped to a previous page. So the cupcake page became like super mouse shaped and disformed because the watercolor like got it wet, and then it just dries in weird ways, as watercolor does. But since the bunny page wasn't yet glued or taped down to the following page, it got malformed, but then when I like taped it down, it went back to like a good shape. So I guess I'll only do watercolor on pages that haven't been taped yet, and then tape them afterwards. Let me know if you have any tips on how to keep watercolor pages from getting like really crinkly and crinkly, because I do love the way that it came out. I think it's like probably my favorite spread I've done so far. Just didn't stay looking cute. Then I decided to add my star rating, since this is my book journal. So I gave this book 5 out of 5 stars. It's my favorite book that I've read in a very long time, quite frankly. Nobody is doing it like Bunny. Nobody's doing it like Mona Awad. It is so chilling and weird and camp and just all the things that I love. So here's the finished product. That green got blended in pretty well, I think. Thank you so much for watching. Like and subscribe for more.